Fundamentals of software testing. What is testing and what is it not? What is considered proper testing? Testing is systematic, so you just cannot ad hoc push buttons and hope that there will be some bugs found or something like that. If you are just randomly trying out some buttons and writing some text to input fields, that is merely trying out that software works when one should systematically try to break it. Debugging is not testing. It is a task that happens when testing has found an error. Then you do debugging and try to figure out why this error has happened and how it should be fixed. And proper testing is conducted by proper testers. So people who can run the program are not necessarily proper testers. So for example, when the testing is carried out by the customer can be some kind of a business person who is not a proper tester also, although he or she should do testing, at least the acceptance testing, but there should also be from the vendor side, the proper testers who know how to do the testing. Because the tester as an occupation requires skills. You cannot be a tester and just you just cannot take some guy from the street and say that okay, now you are going to be the tester. No, but to be a proper tester, you need education and then some time in the field. And the testing itself, it really cannot be done in a fixed time frame. In waterfall model, the testing is the last task, and usually in the end of the software development, there is not really time to do testing, because all the previous steps have made have taken more time than it should have, and then the testing is really pushed to limits in a time-wise. And that doesn't work. But if you just decide that okay, we have 1 month for testing, it's probably not gonna work. It might take 2 weeks, it might take 2 months. You really don't know how much there are faults in the program before you start testing. And that's the reason for this is that every piece of software is unique. Every testing is unique. Every piece of software is unique. Because if it's not unique, then you just copy it and deliver it as a copy. But if you are developing a new system, then it's unique. And then there is this concept of software inspection, which is also known as static testing. Testing can be static or dynamic. Dynamic testing is the one mostly discussed in this course. And it means that code is run to find bugs. So there is actual programming is run. And in static testing, the program is not run, but its documentation is read through. And you can just read source code and to see if there is some crazy parts or security holes and such. And you can also inspect documentation to find if there are irrelevant requirements or requirements that require way too much work or anything like that. And inspections can be done for the requirements or test plan or a business plan or basically anything related to building a software. And the aim is to identify defects at the early stage, of course. The earlier you get it, the better. And it actually can be automated. For example, Facebook has been automating this code inspections. They have software to do the code inspections for millions of lines of code. Instead, it is not run and then to see if there are errors, but the actual source code is inspected to identify some security holes or bad habits used in the code or something like that. Both static and dynamic, they help to develop better code and save money. Then there are seven principles of software testing. They have been developed by the International Software Testing Qualification Board, ISTQB. It is founded in 2002, which means that it is founded in this millennium, and although software has been built for at least 70 years, it took something like 50 years until there was this kind of a international board. So testing has been taken seriously only in this millennium. Now it has been taken seriously before, but it's taken more serious now. So this organization certifies testers, and there is a subunit, Finnish Software Testing Board, which can certify Finnish testers if you are interested. I think that LUT has been working with these organizations. So ISTQB lists seven principles, and these are good starting points when you are doing testing. First, testing shows presence of defects. We have been discussing this. The purpose of testing is to find errors. Testing reduces the probability of undiscovered errors remaining in the software. There can still be errors, but it reduced the probability. And still, even with extremely heavy and professional testing, there is no guarantee that software have not have errors. So there still might be some errors, but less. And exhaustive testing is not possible. Of course, there is no way that everything could be tested. One needs to estimate what are the most important parts of the code to prioritize the testing process. And probably those parts which have a high risk to fail the whole program, those should be really tested heavy. And the ones with processing sensitive data, we have nowadays GDPR in EU, so everything related to sensitive data is extremely important to test. For example, if we have some kind of a hospital software and there are patients' logs there, and those should never ever fail to go to the public internet or something like that. And of course, we need to prioritize those that are important for customer, and they really can be completely different from the two above. So they can prioritize very, very different things. But of course, customer is paying the software, so you prioritize those and make sure there is time for testing. Third one, early testing. Testing has to be started as early as possible. We have been discussing this. Basically, not a single line of code needs to be written before some parts of the software can be tested. There is always a way to analyze, inspect, and test the requirement analysis, for example, or user interface mockups. They are a good place to start to see if customer and vendor are speaking the same language. When vendor has been released the first vision or mockup of the user interface, customer probably wants to see if it's what they want, and usability professionals see that okay, this and this part needs to be a little tweak it to make it better and these kind of things. Four, defect clustering. So there is a saying that 20% of modules include 80% of bugs. So there are parts in code that are harder to implement, thus there might be more faults. And testing can focus on those parts that are having clusters of defects, but it doesn't mean that those other parts should be removed from testing. Everything should be tested, but you can focus on those parts that are probably bringing more bugs. Then 5, pesticide paradox. New tests are required and existing ones need to be reviewed and revised. So what does this mean? It means that otherwise the existing bugs are killed, but new ones are not even found. Thus the bugs are resilient to the pesticide, which in this case is the testing. So this means that when you have written your tests, you probably will get the program to go through those tests, and test says that it's okay. So your program works for those tests, but then you need to bring new tests in to see if the program works also with those tests. And you also need to improve testing techniques and processes continuously. If there are new processes, new models, new findings from the area of software engineering, and bring those new ideas into the testing process. Otherwise, you are basically sitting duck for new bugs. Testing is context dependent. Testing is very different whether one is testing mobile game versus embedded system in solar power plant. And also the testing process should be flexible enough so that it can adapt to different fields. You don't want to build a so strict, tight testing process that you can only test a specific computer game with that process. That's probably not good, because the company can decide that they are making a totally different computer game. So then if the testing process does not work, then you need to build a new process, and that's not a good. 7, the absence of errors fallacy. It really doesn't matter if the software is technically perfect and there are no bugs, if it's unusable or does not really meet the needs of the customer. So you need to think about what customer wanted, and then you build that kind of a software. Not your task is not build a perfect software that is not wanted by the customer. So you need to focus on the right thing. And you remember that also required analysis or business models, etc., these can be tested and inspected, and they helped you to keep on the right track to build software that is the one that customer is wanting. And as a conclusion, testing is hard work done by professionals. Testing can be started before the software has been programmed. And you need to remember that also requirements, manuals, business model, all these things can be tested or inspected. And ISTQB lists 7 principles, which are a good starting point to understand the complexity of software testing.